like the king of New York said, my feelings are dead. Bitch.
But let's move on to the next thing. Mm-hmm. Little beef going on between Kanye and fucking Justin Timberlake Yeezy. So obviously when Kanye was in London, he's getting a bit hyped now. About, okay, let me say it like this, yeah. Kanye is my nigga. Like, Kanye is actually my number one rapper. I'm not saying he's the best rapper in the world, but he's my number one rapper. Yeah. But sometimes Kanye does have to be reined in a bit. So when he's on stage and he's saying he's got love for a whole being fucking with that suit and tie shit, yeah.
Remind me again why the Grammys could suck my dick. Remind me again who's the original Superfly. And I got love but hope, but I ain't fucking with that suit and tie.
Yeah, to me, that's a little bit of a disrespect for a couple reasons. Reason number one, when Kanye was just first starting in the game and Justin was first starting in the game, he's a big major fan of Justin. Like, he used to say that him and Justin, the new Michael Jackson and Prince of the music world. He was a big fan of JT, yeah?
They've done music together though, didn't they?
Huh?
They've done the music together.
No, I don't think they've been on the track together, nah.
Yeah. It's called Stronger or something like that. Baby, you're making it.
But listen, so all these years later, yeah. So obviously, he might not like the track, yeah. But the reason why I think it's disrespectful to air it out like that publicly is because number one, your niggas on the track, your best friend, your mentor, your brothers on the track. So for Jay-Z to be on the track, yeah, you say you got love for Hov, but you ain't fucking with that track. That's a bit disrespectful because you're saying the track's shit. It's like Kanye. What, I don't know. Okay, when Kanye done a track with Estelle. And then Jay-Z's like, yeah, I like Kanye, but I ain't fucking with that shit. When that's like a big track, you know what I mean? Suit and Tie's a big track. Yeah. And then the other reason I don't like it, what he said, is because, to be honest, hip-hop's different. People go at each other, innit? You just diss people, whatever, yeah? But when you're in a certain field, yeah, you shouldn't be disrespecting someone else's craft. Especially someone like Kanye, when you know that you put so much effort into your work. And if someone else on the same level as you are in the music world, just this is your shit, you're going to get mad. So that's why I think it's a little bit disrespectful. But what I do like, that Justin like, made a little comeback, little diss Saturday Night Live.
You'd have to watch the video, Kev.
Yeah, I know.
Let me get a good look at it. Ooh, so thick. Now I know why they call it a fatty. And oh, my head's so slick. Got rappers acting dramatic.
But what I wanted to say is, yeah, people don't know that Justin's like that. A lot of people don't even realize that a few years ago, long time ago now, maybe 05, 06.
And he dropped track bars, made,
huh?
He's dropped bars before.
Yeah, well, there's a track made by Justin Timberlake. What's his name? What's that producer's name? Timberland.
Yeah.
Nelly Furtado. And it's called, I think it's called Give It To Me or something like that. And basically, no, is it called Give It To Me? Of course it's called, yeah. But all three of them are dissing someone, yeah. So the rumor is, and it ain't even a rumor, it's fact, yeah. Like, okay. What was fact is that Timberland was talking about Scott Storch. That was fact, because he said that was true. Yeah. Then what's a rumor is that Nelly Furtado was talking about Fergie. She said that ain't true, but we know it's true. And then they say that Justin was talking about Prince and Janet Jackson. That was like, that's the thing. If you listen to the lyrics, yeah, yeah, you talk about Janet Jackson, because the week that track came out, a week after she was on Oprah Winfrey saying that she ain't chatting to him anymore because when he ripped the thing off her breast and whatnot. So on the track, he says something like, "I saw you on TV last week looking cute, red, tear, tear." And then he said, but then you know that, you know when she sings there, she don't sing loud, innit? She mumbles, innit?
Yeah.
And he's like, I saw you on TV, red, tear, tear. He goes, but you need to speak up. I see you mumbling, red, red, red. And then also the last bit to kill it was, that's when she dropped her album as well, and the album flopped. And he said, I saw you on the chart somewhere down there, red, tear, tear, stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? So,
do you think in any way that Justin Timberlake left you hanging out there? I am speaking to Miss Jackson. Do you?
Well, all the emphasis was put on me, mm-hmm. not on Justin. And Justin, we were friends. Mm-hmm. And not that we aren't now, we haven't spoken, but I consider him a friend, and I'm very loyal, and friendship is very important. And I have to say, just to let people know that Justin has reached out to we haven't spoken, but has reached out to speak with me, and like I said, friendship is very important to me, and certain things you just don't do to friends. Yeah. And in my own time, I'll give
so
him a call.
So when you say certain things you just don't do to friends, do you think him ripping the whole thing off? Is that what
you're talking about? No. When you had said, certain things were said supposedly, or that he had said, uh-huh. During that whole fiasco, uh-huh. I had heard. Mm-hmm. And kind of leaving you out there hanging.
So you do feel that he left you hanging?
To a certain degree, yeah.
Okay.
Could you speak up and stop my mumbling? I don't think you came in clear. Sitting on the top, it's hard to hear you from way up here. I saw you trying to act cute on TV, just let me clear the air. We missed you on the charts last weekend, that's right, you wasn't there.
He's like that, ain't it? He will come back at you say something about
sly. Him. He's sly. He was sly with Kanye, bro.
I don't think he gives a fuck who you are.
He said Kanye is dramatic, bruv.
Kanye is my boy, but sometimes he does get dramatic, though, you have to say.
Yeah. Guy said, I got tracks making rappers dramatic.
I ain't even gonna lie, that was fucking funny, like.
Bro, no. This is what I'm saying, I didn't see the point in what Kanye was trying to make.
Yeah, me neither. Say he's my boy, but why say that? It's just disrespectful, man. Why say that?
I don't know. Maybe he's trying to make a point, or maybe he's jealous that Jay-Z's on the track. I don't know what the fuck is up. When I heard that, I thought, yeah. So, I thought Justin won't come back with nothing, you know. Then he come out, did his little show thing. I just said, rare, rappers this, and I thought, You never notice, you know, because when you're watching it, you're thinking, yeah, just singing normally. Then he switched it up because you have Jay-Z come on the stage and he's doing his thing. Then he goes back into his thing and then he just sings it. And everyone in the crowd was like, oh, but they noticed it after.
I thought, wow, he did rewind it back,
you get me? And I thought, seriously, a new one, let it go. Because it was embarrassing, man. You're in front of thousands and you're saying, I don't like that. And then, you know, the crowd went crazy when Kanye said that, you know. Crowd went crazy. We're like, oh, shit. I thought, oh, yeah, that was stupid. But a lot of people liked it because it hyped it up. Mm-hmm. But what do you think of the track? What do you think of Justin's track, though?
You know what? I like it. That's another thing that's pissing me off. Yeah? Everyone's just talking shit at the moment, yeah? Justin's a guy here that, like, he's a sick, like, obviously he's a white guy and everything, so for him to be doing, like, this R&B thing, he's been doing it since day one, he's been sick since day one, first album successful, second album even more successful, like, he was that guy, he was, like, the next, he was, like, rivaling Usher back then, do you know what I'm saying?
He's a dancer,
he's a sick singer, all that, and then now he's come back and everyone's like, oh, the tracks he's putting out ain't that good, and what do you mean they're not that good?
When he's rocking with, what you call it?
Who? Who?
Pharrell for
that. Yeah, first album, yeah, it was Pharrell.
So I'm telling you, he made money at the time.
Kanye
was in the background for like a hot minute.
Yeah, but like the next thing, like, and they're saying he's trying to be like Robin Thicke. How are you going to try to be like Robin Thicke when you was out before Robin Thicke? Do you know what I'm saying? He was busting suit and ties on his second album. Like,
I know.
Talking about, I just hate when people talking rubbish. And like when people just hating, like it just winds me up. Like people just bare hating. I'm not saying I'm some major fan, but it's like when someone's doing good, like people dissing the Saturday Night Live things. I watch it again. I'm like, okay, then he ain't even a nigga, but you know what I mean. The nigga, like he's dancing sick. He's singing sick, singing live, doing what he's doing his thing.
Fam, he was making the money at one time.
Who does that now? Do you know what I'm saying?
I liked his music at one time. He was him, Pharrell, they were just every minute they were coming out with something new.
Yeah.
It's like they clocked it. So, you know, like every month or so you see something new or they come out and he was doing his dancing, even drop a few bars, you know, like,
People know that
I'm versatile, I'm doing this how I want to do it. But Kanye tried to go there, maybe because he wants attention, because that's what a lot of people are saying, attention seeking. Even what's her name, Pink, was saying he's an idiot. Attention-seeking idiot.
I didn't even hear this. But listen, as I keep saying, yeah, Kanye's my number one, isn't it? I'm just saying, even the Taylor Swift thing, I had his back. Even, and that's because she...
What? Are you kidding me?
This I even had his back on that.
Not that he should have done it. Take her shine and get me. Don't see.
No, what I mean is not that he should have done it, but I just felt that, like...
She deserved it. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, she was a bit of an idiot back then. No, she used to get on my nerves a bit, man. She was a bit jarring, innit? I didn't really care too much for her. She was a bit jarring.
Probably made the girl cry. That's not right, man.
But this one's different. This one I think is different. I think it's different because his boy's on the track. Yeah.
Yeah.
Jay's on the track. You know what I mean? Have a bit of respect, man. Do you know what I'm saying? And then,
you're jealous about that, though.
I think it is jealousy because even on the Big Brother track, he said that he wanted to do a song with. Do you know what? It is jealousy because, as I said, he always said he loves Justin Timberlake. Like back in the days, he always said that. And like, when he wanted to do a song with Coldplay, Jay-Z beat him to it, and he was upset. He said that on the Big Brother track.
Hey, I told Jay I did a song with Coldplay. Next thing I know, he got a song with Coldplay. Back in my mind, I'm like, oh, no way. Translate Espanol, no way, Jose.
So it's probably like he wants to do a track with Justin and never got a chance to, whatever. And because Jay-Z's doing it, he's probably getting upset. Like, that's what I don't like, even though he's my number one, whatever. That bit I don't like. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying, but you notice, I've got to say something as well. This is your favourite rapper you're talking about.
That's what I'm saying.
There was a time about 2 years ago, like Kanye West started fading and he started going into some kind of rock thing. I am not going to even lie to you. Don't even try to deny it, you know.
Say that again, he was going into what?
He would start going into like, you know, like doing collaborations with like rock bands or things like that. Like,
I know you weren't doing that. You mean... He did.
Yeah, he was going off some different way. That's when I started falling off him.
That was a long time ago. He done a track with Fall Out Boy.
Yeah, it just, nah, man. I just.
That was a good track, though.
I didn't want to pop with that. I'm sorry, man. You know how we are, hip hop all the way.
Yeah, but Jay-Z's done that. He's done a track. He done an album with Linkin Park.
Yeah, but that album was different. Jay-Z can get away with such things. You know why?
He's done it before. Everyone's done that little rock thing.
BK's finest. That's what I'm saying. Jay-Z's different to that.
Lil Wayne's done it.
Lil Wayne baited it. Lil Wayne didn't even sound right. Since he done that, this guy's doing skateboard skinny jeans.
Yeah, I know. He's gonna be.
Sorry, Lil Wayne, but this guy's going some different way. We're moving off the subject right now.
That's what I was gonna say. Let's wrap this one up here. We'll come back for another video. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So saysatin.com, one we out.
Later.
I ain't making any records dissing, but don't believe me. Go and get a comp or listen. You'll see there is no competition. 2